It's a Thursday, right? We're supposed to be throwing back to things from way, way back when, like the way I threw back to this sweater that y'all called hideous, but I don't care because I like it. I saw something, when was it? It was Mbonya's birthday, I think a couple of days back. So someone posted like a birthday message, and they go like, happy birthday to the man who gave me another life, the man who I'm alive to serve and forever grateful to. Man, I'm reading this post and I'm like, we as Africans are either too ignorant or our faith is something that supersedes understanding. Jesus. Anywho, my name is Sinovius One. Let's leave the things of religion to those who understand it. Let's talk about gossip. Kakati, the latest rumor is he may be the one to start managing Lydia Jasmine. Oh, young people might even begin thinking I have a personal vendetta against Lydia Jasmine, but it's not me. The news finds me. So I got up to news today of a rumor going around that given the fact she's looking for management, she might actually end up with Ronnie Mulindo. I'm like, Ronnie who? Ronnie who? And they're like, no, don't you remember the guy who was with Obsessions? I'm like, wait, slow it down. You mean Sharon O's husband? Jesus is the Lord. The fossil came to show. Jasmine, I don't know what you're going for. I don't know what you're looking for. But damn, you might as well try your hand with Ronnie. Because, I mean, he has a lot of nothing to do. Some people thought he was actually dead, which is sad. I talked to my producer today and he was like, Ronnie who? Anyway, apparently that's the guy she might be ending up with in management. I'm like, I don't even have words anymore. Let me just wait for the rumors to stop and then I'll get words. For now though, that's the rumor. Tulia Chokureti. So, Vipa Maker, a lot is built up around him. You remember I'm always doing stories about him not showing up for concerts. I'm always doing stories about him acting out a certain type of way. And we were blaming it on management. Now, Fick came out and he had the audacity, yes, I'm saying it, he had the audacity to tell us, yo, Mulabe, my management does not employ me. I employ management. So I was like, wait, what? So if you employ management, it means all these mishaps, all these things of you not showing up for concerts, that's all on you and not on pretty much management. Now, last I heard, him and Karma are still together, but he says him and Karma, he's not a manager. Karma is actually a partner. I'm like, so wait, what are we partnering in? Like, that wasn't enough. He goes on to say, I mean, if your concert is a sigenze, kobichibichi, I'm be okay, all on ground will be fine and all of that. It goes back to what Kuku said. You know, at times I don't want to listen to what his name is. This guy, Kuku. Kasuku, that one. Kasuku actually said it. Kasuku nagamba kanakane chikendo kasula chintu chimum gayisa gabi. And by the looks of it, I think this is it. This is it happening. But I don't want to badmouth anyone on this one because I usually do. But I'm sorry. Fick. Everybody's complaining about your angry energy, your negative vibes, you feeling watuka, you feeling your all these things. And this industry doesn't forget. This industry never forgets. And again, this same industry can put you up so high and drop you like a hot potato. You of all people should know this. This is the time for you to become meek. This is the time for you to think humble, for you to think pious, for you to think all those things. You are a star, yes, but this is not Hollywood. Mugenda to Zimbirako and Noverenga is a baking powder. The thing I'm trying to say here is, Fick, you are talented. We get it. We actually love to listen to your music, but you need to tone it down a notch. A notch! And when I say a notch, it is from like here. Mpaka wano. We talk about the same idiots, they do the same ish, and we never, ever, ever get out of our comfort zone to tell them, you know what, we can't deal with your BS. Anyway, that's what he has to say. I can't even deal. Today I will not deal with much. I can't. The argument on the streets of Kampala has been won. Bebe Cool opened a shop. No, Zuena opened her cake shop. Finally got an address. She's been doing it in the corridors of her house and all that. So she finally got an address and the masses came out to criticize Bebe Cool. Now, if we all know, Bebe Cool is the guy who's always telling us, I'm flying out of these countries. He's the guy who is doing all of these things. His friends, BFFs with the president. I think the masses expected you to have like a good showroom, you know, because I also looked at the showroom. I'm sorry to say, but nange sisobola gulawo cake. Now he came out, he lashed out. He's like, yo, mindset is amwe chomvamla amugenda po bwavu. Don't worry, this is when a Parks had 200 million Mercedes to go into a shop worth 300k. I'm like, that's consolation. But when you look at the financial bit, the way he was talking about it, it kind of made sense. But the frugalness with your brand, no, I'm sorry, I can't. I have tried to take sides on this. I have tried to be like, you know what, Pepe Kuhn makes a lot of sense because I'm a frugal person like that. But then when I'm looking at you and your wife and how you are a brand, boo boo, 300k, that car plus looks horrible. It's bad. We can't buy cakes from there. Actually, she should have stayed home. Made those cakes from home. I could eat the cakes from your home any day. But from that dusty place, no, I'm sorry, I can't. No. So on that note, I am going to join the Ugandans and say yes. Financially speaking, it makes sense, but I am sorry. With the visual appeals to us more. If you ever want to do anything, the visual, you know, kusikiriza. Haven't you seen everybody with a cake business? Come on. Come on. Our former KCC Ed actually had a cake house. Yeah, she's called the cake lady. And she also had a cake this. Why did you go and find the cake space in the supermarket? Or on one of those malls. But, No, at times, Masi Nabigambo. Masi Nabigambo, but hey, it's his family and that's how he explained it. That's how he explained it. I'm not dealing. Today is Thursday. Tomorrow is a Friday. I do not want to deal with any BS today. I'm just giving you the news the way I get it. I am tired. Woo, child. The masses want a decent place. Evasikiriza, and I also understand the masses. So, yeah. Big shout out to all the loyal Scoop and Scoop fans. Now we have something very exciting about to happen. You will be the first to know when it does go down. I know most of you are asking, why is she not on her usual background? Like for the past couple of days, I've been using my outside background with, of course, a huge thingy of me. Well, we have some exciting news. Hit me up in the comment section and let me know what do you think I have planned out for you. It's going to be a lit year for Scoop. Do it! We are going to have so much fun with this. Anywho, that's been my 10 minutes. At Tina Fierce 1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce 1. Like and follow the pages. On Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce 1 with an H. Don't forget to like. Hit the like button. Yes, on YouTube. Hit it. I'm out. Peace.